I'm Johnny Pitts.
And I'm Kirsten O'Brien. Welcome to Yum! Zac Efron's coming to stay.
It's the only show... What?
Sorry, it was worth a try.
Not really. Welcome to Help! Teacher's coming to stay. The only show that puts you in charge of your teacher.
So what happens when the pupil calls the shots?
What are the chances of falling?
Depends how good you are.
There's fun. Via.
Can I come down?
No.
So I need to come down.
And lots of falling.
To play.
Help! Teacher's coming to stay.
You're it.
Help! Help! Teacher's coming to stay. Keep down, we don't want anyone to see us. I'm here at the Bishop's High School in Chester, where I've got a surprise for one of the pupils. They're all in there thinking this is a regular Friday afternoon, and at the end of the lesson, they'll be free of school for the weekend. But for one pupil, things are gonna be a little bit different. Instead of spending the weekend chilling out, they're gonna be taking home their very own teacher. Follow me. I love this bit. Let's do it. Hello, everybody. I'm Johnny Pitts from CBBC. Are you Miss Chase?
Oh, yeah.
By any chance? Lovely to meet you, Miss Chase. I'm Johnny.
Hi.
Did you have any plans this weekend at all?
Not really.
No.
That's good to know. Okay. Could everybody stand up, please?
Hi.
If you're a boy, you can sit down. If your name doesn't begin with B, you can also sit down. That only leaves one girl here, so you must be Becky.
Yeah.
Am I right? Come on then, Becky, come to the front. Give her a round of applause, everyone. Becky.
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Brilliant, because you're going to be taking home your teacher for the entire weekend, and you've got to teach your two favourite hobbies.
Sounds good. I'm up for it.
You're up for it, yeah?
Yeah.
She's got to sit a final exam on Monday morning.
Yeah.
And if you pass, the whole class are involved because they'll go on an amazing day out.
Yeah!
However, if you fail to teach Miss Chase properly and she fails that exam on Monday, it's going to be a gross gunking for you both.
Oh,
right, okay, Becky, come on, put her out of her misery.
Miss Chase, you're going to be learning rock climbing and kayaking.
I hate heights. I really hate heights. And with the kayaking, does that mean I'd get my hair wet?
Yeah.
I hate getting my hair wet.
So, you hate heights and you hate getting your hair wet. Not the best start to the weekend. How are you going to teach your teacher those two hobbies then?
I'm going to get gunned.
Oh, no, no. But what do you reckon, guys? Reckon they'll do it?
Yeah!
Miss Chase, you need your very own Help Teach school uniform.
Thank you very much.
And to go with that, your school top. There you go. Look at that. Pupil. You know it. But, OK, well, while you get changed, let's find out a little bit more about our dynamic pupil. She's sporty.
Hi. Hey, I'm Becky, and this is my house. Come on in and meet the family. I live here with my mum.
Hello.
My dad.
Hi.
My older brother, Matt.
Hey.
And my younger brother, Tom.
Whee!
We're a very active family. We do lots of fun things together. Ow, my head! We also play lots of musical instruments. But my hobbies involve adventure and adrenaline. I love rock climbing. I've been doing it since I was 5, and I practice every few weeks.
But it's not just heights that I'm into. I learned kayaking from my dad, and I love being in the water.
My lessons are definitely not going to be boring. Okay, Miss Chase, well, the bell's gone, so let's bring it on. Pupil power!
Wow, it looks like it's going to be a high-octane weekend. Let's find out a bit more about Miss Chase and what she gets up to outside of school.
Hi, I'm Miss Chase, head of lower school at Bishop's Bluecoat in Chester, and this is my house. I live here with my cat, Scruffy.
Meow.
After a hectic day at school, there's nothing I like doing more than relaxing. I'm not really into sports or outdoor activities, but I do enjoy the theatre and I've been known to dabble with a bit of amateur dramatics.
Farewell. God knows when we shall meet again.
But my ultimate favourite pastime is splashing out on a few beauty treatments. It's going to be strange being a pupil again, as I can be a little bit of a control freak.
Well, the bell has gone and the pressure is well and truly on.
Come on then, Miss Chase. What do you reckon, guys? So how are you feeling?
Very nervous, actually. Okay. Really nervous, Becky.
All right, now the roles are officially reversed. I think it's time we see how you two are going to get on this weekend, OK? What do you reckon, guys? Should we put them to the test?
Yeah!
It's time for the compatibility challenge. OK, guys, here is the deal. As the weekend's going to be full of adventure, I've come up with a little adventure-themed compatibility challenge for you, OK? I like to call it the Wild Animal Water Rescue. Imagine this is the river, and it's flooded its banks, leaving all these wild animals stranded on these four islands. Using a canoe, you've got to rescue these animals. Now, you can never touch the floor or anything like that. And you'll notice that there's a piranha and there's two crocodiles. You can't touch those, otherwise you'll get 10 seconds deducted off your time. You've got 3 minutes to complete this challenge, and you've got to get all the animals off the island and into your net.
There you go.
And your very own survival
outfit.
Thank you very much.
Here you go. And here is your canoe with your very own paddles that are also plungers.
So you have to get in that?
Well, yeah, that is the general idea.
Okay.
Miss Chase.
So I have to get in that, get across the river.
Yep.
And pick up the animals, but not the crocodiles.
You both have to get in this, yeah, that's right.
At the same time?
At the
same
time. We can't touch crocodiles.
No, you can't touch crocodiles, okay? Remember, this is a compatibility challenge, so you need to work together as a team to make this happen.
It's not that complicated, Miss Chase. Looks like these poor animals are never going to get rescued at this rate.
Okay, guys, are you ready?
Yeah. Ready, Beck.
Ready.
I've
We're
got
ready.
To throw something in as well. If you manage to complete this compatibility challenge successfully, you're going to have a lovely dinner tonight. You're going to have some pasta, which I know is one of your favourite dishes, isn't it?
Yeah.
However, if you fail, it's going to be cold, horrible, leftover school dinners for both of you.
Oh, no.
OK?
Yeah.
It's a lot of pressure. Good luck, guys. Get in the boat.
Come on, Bex.
You're going
to
fun.
Woo!
I swear it's going to break.
Here are your paddles.
Right, these are paddles?
Okay.
Well, the plungers, technically, but, you know.
Right, and I've got to get it across the river.
Miss Chase really isn't getting the hang of this.
Whoa. Your 3 minutes starts now. Come on, guys, let's give them some support. Hey, that's one. Well done, guys. It's a work as a team here. Come on, you can do it. Come on, guys.
Ooh, the cheetah was nearly in the river.
Brilliant, okay. That's 40 seconds gone.
That's good technique. They're using the paddle plunger to knock the animals into the net.
Don't touch the piranhas. Come on.
They've avoided the piranhas. Oh, but it's a close call with the crocodile. Phew, nicely done.
It's the final one. A minute and 15 gone, they're doing amazingly well.
Yeah!
Yeah, you've done it!
Oh, yeah.
Let's see how you've done.
Maybe you should get out first.
You look like such an intrepid explorer as well, up until then. What happened?
Kayak, I would have been in the water.
Yeah.
You would have. You'd have been in the UK, yeah. Whoa.
Well, the canoe is done for, but have they succeeded in winning a treat for their tea?
You've rescued all four wild animals and you did it in under 2 minutes. That's absolutely amazing. You've passed your compatibility challenge. It's nice pasta for you this evening at dinner. Give it a high five, guys.
Oh, yeah.
Let's go back.
Result.
Miss Chase heads to the staff room to show off her new uniform.
My outfit for
for the weekend.
Oh, right. Very nice.
So, do you know what you're doing?
Just been told I'm doing kayaking and rock climbing. I hate getting wet and I don't like heights, so not looking forward to it.
Nice. Mama's chase, time to go home. We'll start practicing.
You lot have a lovely, relaxing weekend, won't you?
Will you?
Becky's taking control, but will Miss Chase survive her new role as a student?
I think the thing that Miss Chase is going to find the hardest will be the kayaking, because she doesn't like getting her hair wet, so I really don't think she'll enjoy that.
It'll be quite amusing, I think, to see how she does, but she'll give it her best shot.
But before Miss Chase confronts her fears, it's time to meet the family.
Hi, this is Matt.
I know, Matt. Matt. Chase. You don't normally see me unless it's an assembly. I'm sorry, I've come to stay.
So here is the kitchen. And this is my mum.
Hi.
Mum's Miss Chase.
Nice to meet you.
This is my dad.
Hi. Hello, Miss Chase. Welcome to our house.
Nice to meet you.
It's my brother Dwayne. This is my little brother Tom.
Hi, Tom.
This is Miss Chase.
Tom. Nice to meet you.
Hi, Miss Chase.
Okay, Miss Chase, this is my room. We'll be staying here for the next few days.
Very nice.
So unpack, make yourself at home, and I want you down in 10 minutes.
Thank you.
Teaching Miss Chase my hobbies is going to be hard because she said she's terrified of heights. So that's terrible for rock climbing. And she said she hates getting wet and getting her hair wet, which is terrible for kayaking.
When Becky first told me what activities I was going to be doing, I did feel really quite apprehensive, as I really don't like heights. And as for kayaking, well, I know I'm not very good at balancing and therefore I will end up in the water.
Becky will probably boss her about a lot because when she's in charge, it's sort of her way. Yeah, and that normally is always, like on the TV, always wants her channel.
Buon appetito, eh?
Thank you.
This is Johnny's quattro cheese pasta bake. I got taught by the masters in Italy how to make that. So I hope you enjoy it, okay?
Thank you.
You did really well in the compatibility challenge earlier, and usually I take great pride in serving up cold leftover school dinners at this point. But this week I haven't been able to do that.
Well done, Bex.
Yeah.
How are you feeling at this point? You're both confident?
Yeah.
Confident.
Hungry and tired,
but confident. Confident, yeah.
Well, listen, you can go and tuck into that and I hope you enjoy.
Thanks.
I'm quite hungry and I've realised I've not cooked enough for me there, so could I just pinch? If that's all right.
No, sorry.
Okay, I'll just have the leftover school dinners.
Yeah.
Night, fam.
Bye.
Becky can be a little bit bossy, so I think she's going to be really quite hard with me, and if I don't do things properly, she will tell me.
I think I won't need to be too strict. I think we'll have some fun. I think she'll get into it by the end of the weekend. I think she'll want to do it again. Actually, no, maybe she won't, no.
Coming up, there's highs.
And you're doing really good.
No, I'm stuck, Becky.
There's pies. And there's a few failed tries. It's Saturday morning, and normally around this time, Miss Chase would be in bed, maybe watching a bit of TV, having a lie-in. But today, she's got to face two of her biggest fears: heights and getting her hair wet. I reckon Becky is going to have a work cut out.
Come on, Miss Chase, time to get up.
Oh, it's way too early.
It's time for your first lesson. I want you down in 10 minutes.
Oh, just woke up this morning. I think I only probably had about 2 hours sleep. I couldn't sleep when I went to bed, just worrying about the activities today.
With the rules up on the board, Becky's ready to take charge.
Now I must take the register. Miss Chase?
Here, miss.
You are here. Okay, let's make a start. Your rules are keep your book neat, be punctual, no mobile phones, and put your hand up to talk. Is that all okay?
Yes, miss. Yeah.
Now, the punishments are, if you are naughty, you have to wear the naughty hat. And then, if you're naughty again, you've got to wear an I've been naughty badge. And if you get 2 badges, you have to go and clean out my rabbit.
Good morning, you two.
Morning.
How are you both feeling about the day ahead?
Oh, it's good.
I'm a bit nervous because I really don't want to break any rules because I don't like getting my hands dirty and I don't want to clean out a rabbit.
Right, no, I bet you don't. I don't blame you. Becky, what sort of teacher do you think you're going to make over the weekend?
I'm not going to be mean, but she still won't get away with anything.
and it's going to be a lot of fun.
Right, have a good one, and your lesson time starts now.
OK, Miss Chase, I've been rock climbing for about 4 or 5 years. I'm going to start off with some basic equipment. This is called a carabiner. OK?
A what, sorry?
Carabiner. Miss, you have lots of different types of carabiners. This is called a twist gate carabiner. When it twists closed, it can't open. So it's a lot safer than this one. If it's rubbing against something, it can just open. Or you can use this one, a screw gate carabiner.
Why would you use different ones then?
The main carabiners, which you clip your harness onto, obviously they need to be extremely safe. Yeah. So you would have either a twist gate or a screw gate. These can be just for putting bits of equipment on.
Let's remember what Becky's dealing with here. She's got to teach someone about rock climbing who's scared of heights. Good luck, Becky. I think you'll need it.
The person that's climbing has a rope. It goes all the way up the top of the wall and all the way down. Now, someone will have the other end of this rope in a device which is called a stitch plate.
Stitch plate?
Yep.
Right. Do you want me to write that down, miss?
Yes. So the person who's belaying you will have this.
Right.
This will go in their harness,
mm-hmm.
and they will have a safety lock on it, which basically means if you fall, they can catch you.
Can I just say, what do you mean if you fall? What are the chances of falling?
Depends how good you are. If you're bad at rock climbing, you may well fall. But don't worry, because we'll be starting off with some easy ones.
Right.
Okay. So if you're abseiling, the person who's belaying you controls it.
Crikey, look at her face. Miss Chase is not happy about the abseiling.
Now we're going to learn a basic figure of eight knot. This is a knot that you use whenever you're climbing, no matter what type of climbing you're doing.
Knots are essential for a safe climb, so pay close attention, Miss Chase.
Rather, didn't it?
No.
Oh.
Back through that. And then pull tight.
Is that right?
That's looking good, yeah.
Fantastic.
That's right. Okay, Miss Chase, there's one last thing you need to learn about the equipment. And it's the most important thing, it's the harness. I'm not going to show you how to put it on now. First, you've got to come with me.
It's time to put the theory into practice at the climbing centre. This is the moment Miss Chase has been dreading all morning.
OK, then Miss Chase, this is the wall you'll be climbing today. Now.
It looks really high, Becky.
Don't want to see, it's fine.
The wall is 9 metres high, and Miss Chase is scared of heights.
Check out the look in Miss Chase's eyes. A mixture of fear and focus.
Is that tight enough?
Yeah, that's tight enough.
Are you sure?
Yep. I'll just use this up.
Is that the knot that's going to save me if I do fall?
Yes.
So it's definitely tight enough?
Yeah, it's definitely tight enough.
Sure?
Yep.
Even to hold my weight?
Yep, to hold your weight. It's all tight enough. Trust me, OK? What do you call this, miss?
A screw gate... Caribbean. No, a screw gate...
Carabiner.
Oh, that's it.
Yes, well,
a screw gate carabiner.
Okay, right.
I hope Miss Chase's climbing is better than her memory.
Okay, Miss Chase, I'm going to do a demo for you. I'm going to go up this wall.
Okay.
Okay. Wow, look at Becky go.
I'm feeling really nervous at the moment. I really don't think I'm going to get very far up that wall, but. I want to. I really want to conquer my fear and get up there, but I don't think I'm going to be able to.
Hi, Becky.
Wow.
Hiya.
She's so comfortable up there. I wonder if it's going to be the same for Miss Chase. I think not.
There's no way I could get that high up. Oh, I couldn't do that bit. Oh, well done.
Bravo, Becky, all the way to the top. Now let's see what Miss Chase is made of.
Oh, man.
Right, guys, try to stick to the oranges, because they're better handholds. You're doing really good, Miss Chase. Come on. Don't look down. Don't look down.
Oh, my Lord, please. Don't.
You know how teachers sometimes say that their pupils are driving them up the wall? Well, after this weekend, Miss Chase can say that with more meaning than ever.
You promise you're not going to drop me?
He won't, honestly.
Oh, man.
Come on, Miss Chase, you can do it. Yeah, put your left foot on the one above it.
I've forgotten which foot right and left is.
Right, put this foot on him.
Poor Miss Chase. She's so scared she can't even remember her left from her right.
Go on, you can.
Oh.
Move your left foot higher.
I can't.
You can do it, you can.
No, I'm stuck, Becky. Oh, man, can you get me down?
Yeah, sure. Miss Chase, go on, you can do it.
No, I can't. I'm stuck now.
Get your hands on good hold.
Oh, no, Miss Chase is starting to panic. I hope she doesn't lose her composure.
Can I come down?
No.
No, I need to come down.
No. Put your blue foot... Put your foot on the blue handhold.
Can I come down?
No, go on, no, don't come down. You're doing really good. No, just lower
okay.
down.
Down we go!
That's it, you're doing really well. Ben,
that is horrendous.
You did really
no,
well.
No, I can't do that again.
Go, you did really well. You've got to keep trying, honestly.
That won't happen. I can't get to the top. That's the furthest I can go.
Miss Chase, are you okay?
No.
You are not happy up there, were you?
No, not at all. I panicked. It's so much, you think you're so much higher than you are, and I just froze, panicked. My arms are trembling, my legs are trembling. I don't think it's for me.
But don't forget that on Monday morning, you're going to be sitting a final exam. What if it's in rock climbing?
Well, I failed.
You're going to get gunged.
If the test on Monday is on rock climbing, I'm not sure.
I haven't got a chance of passing that. It's so difficult. It is definitely not for me. Oh,
this climbing lock. It's a doddle. I mean, how can anyone be scared of heights? It's all in the mind. Oh. Oh.
Back on the ground, Miss Chase is hoping the rest of the day will be a slam dunk.
Yeah. Yes!
It's Johnny Pitts on the offensive. Oh, he shoots!
And he misses.
Playtime's over now, guys. What were you doing playing around anyway? We've got lots of work to do. How did you find the first lesson?
The lesson was very good, the teacher was very good, but the pupil was pretty rubbish.
Oh, okay. No, you weren't. It was in the first go, wasn't it? So
it was.
Try the best.
OK, well, with that in mind, marks out of 10.
Maybe 7?
Seven out of 10.
Not bad. Okay. 7 out of 10.
Not bad.
I'm pleased with that.
Plenty of room for improvement, though.
Yeah, I suppose, yeah.
Now, you did only have 45 minutes on your last lesson. How would you like to win an extra 15 minutes?
No, that'd be good, actually. That'd be
a
good.
Lot
okay. It's time for the time challenge. Hello and welcome to Pizza's Peculiar Pies. Come in, girls. I love a good pie meat, which is why I've made 10 pies, each with their own unique flavour. What you've got to do is guess the flavour of each pie. You've got to be wearing these so you can't see what you're going to be eating. There you go. Take that. And so you don't dilly-dally over your deliberations, you're going to be timed, OK? So you'll only have 3 minutes. Now, for each pie you correctly guess the flavour of, can win a minute of extra time. So that's 10 pies, 10 minutes. If you get all 10 pies, I'm a nice guy. I'll give you an extra 5 minutes. So that's 15 minutes of extra time you're playing for.
So basically, we're putting our faces in the pie.
That's right. You've got to...
Our faces?
..mash your way through the pastry and correctly guess the flavour. Put the goggles on.
Is there anything horrible in these pies?
Oh, no, just regular
pies. I'm not at liberty to divulge that information.
But I can tell you lot at home that there's a right old selection of yucky bits in these beauties.
Ready, steady, pie. Nibble your way through the pastry. Go on, push your way. Go on.
Go on, what is it?
Custard?
Custard, Miss Chase, yeah?
Yeah.
OK. Go on, Rebecca.
Oh, what is that?
Come on.
Oh, wait, gravy!
That's gravy, okay.
Oh,
that's
horrible. What?
30 seconds gone.
Jelly?
Any flavour?
Apricot?
Apricot jelly.
Mm. Oh, peas, mushy peas.
That's
horrible.
Peas.
That is really horrible.
Okay, beans.
Soup,
disgusting.
That's actually
we have to hurry up, guys. That's a minute and 15. Go on. What do you think?
Custard.
Custard,
oh,
okay.
I like custard.
Yeah, it wasn't too bad, that one, actually.
Oh, please don't be disgusting.
Go on, have a guess.
Jam.
What kind of jam?
Raspberry.
How many
more pies have we got?
What is that? Soup!
You're almost there.
What do you
think? Soup! You're going for soup, yeah?
Yeah. Okay.
That's 2 minutes gone. Okay, come on, your final pie. Get right in there.
I'm suffocating in a pie! Okay. Mashed potato?
Mashed potato. Okay.
Can I go?
Yeah, go for it.
Custard.
Gonna have to hurry you up.
What is it, Betty? Custard.
Custard. Do you think that's custard?
That's good. I'm a two that are custard.
Okay.
That's not too bad.
Okay, time is up, guys. Come in. Let's see how you've done. You're laughing at Becky, but Miss Chase, you're answering yourself in a way, have you?
Custard, that can't be right.
For the first pie, you thought it was custard.
Yeah.
When it was actually mashed bananas.
No!
What
was that? Mashed bananas!
For the second pie, saved on gravy.
Yeah,
excellent.
Well done, Becky.
Okay, for the third pie, it was actually orange jelly.
Oh, come on, you're gonna give me that! Jelly.
You said mushy peas for the fourth pie.
Yes!
Mushy peas, right? Oh. Okay. Fifth pie, you said beans. It was actually vegetable soup.
I am officially rubbish.
For the sixth pie, it was rice pudding.
No.
Similar. The seventh pie, you said it was raspberry jam.
Yeah,
and it was raspberry jam.
High five for that.
Eighth pie, you said it was soup. It was actually beans.
No.
Yeah. The ninth pie was mashed potato. Well done. And for the final pie, you said it was custard.
It's gotta be custard.
Three guesses at custard between
you.
It was custard, brilliant. Listen, guys, you've got 5 minutes of extra time for your next lesson, and that next lesson is in kayaking, so I suggest you guys go and get ready for the next lesson. Okay, on to the kayaking lesson. And it looks like Becky's running quite a tight ship. Good time. Good.
With no time to lose, Becky's straight into the theory.
Kayaks originate from Eskimos who made them out of animal skins. But now, modern days, they're made out of fiberglass.
What did they used to be made from?
Animal skins.
Animal skin, okay.
I hope that's neat.
Just rough notes, miss.
Okay, so you'd be writing up in neat later?
Yeah.
Now, there's lots of different types of kayaks. You've got a sea kayak, which is long, and it's very pointed at the end, so it can glide through the waves easily. Now, you also have a stunt kayak, and rather than being pointed on the end, it's more of a stub on the end. So it's easier to move about in, easier to turn, but it's not so good to go in a straight line.
What was the difference then between the sea kayak and the sky kayak?
Stunt kayak.
Oh, sorry, and what's kayak?
Stunt.
Oh, stunt, sorry, I thought you said sky. And the stunt kayaks?
Yeah.
That's not what we're using, is it?
No.
Right.
Now, with kayaking, there's not so much theory. There's more getting in the water and doing it.
Becky's hoping Miss Chase will fare better on the water than she did on the climbing wall.
One leg in?
Yep. Whoa, that's it, well done.
Okay.
Here's your paddle.
Okay, so that one is...
Yep. Going in vertical.
Yep.
And twist.
Twist.
And then, okay. I want you to have a go. Kayak about, see where you can go. Ooh. Well done, you're doing really well.
Have a turn round.
Turn. So if you want to go left, put your paddle in right.
Okay.
The more you experiment, the more you will get to grips with it.
Okay, so far so good for Miss Chase. She's got inside the kayak in one piece.
It's like being on a pony. It's like, oh my God.
Looks like Miss Chase is actually enjoying kayaking and she's managed to keep her hair dry. I think it's time to take the lesson to the next level, Becky.
Can we play a little balance game?
Yeah, okay.
Try kneeling in the kayak, okay? Well, I'm sure you can do it. That's it.
I bet you want to see that again.
Oh, Becky, my hair is wet.
And now that you're wet,
You can just carry on getting better, Miss.
Nice try, Becky, but I don't think Miss Chase is convinced.
Okay. Right, I'm going to do this time, Becky.
Yep.
I'm going to go all the way to the bottom, turn around and come back.
Looking good, Miss Chase. She's starting to get the hang of this. Well, nearly.
Are you OK? Don't worry.
Hello, you two.
Hello.
How did you find the lesson in the kayaking, Miss Chase?
Enjoyed it.
Really?
Yeah, I did. OK, I got my hair wet. You capsized a couple of times.
That was one of your fears,
yeah,
wasn't it?
Yeah, but overall, much better than the first hobby. And I think I've got the hang of it.
So, Becky, a mark out of 10, please, then, for the kayak lesson.
Well, considering it was her first time,
yeah,
and she'd never gone in a kayak before in her life, I would give her a 9.
Fantastic.
9 out of 10.
Yeah, I deserve that.
Now, I do think you need to raise the bar just a little bit. So, tomorrow morning, Miss Chase, you're going to be showing off everything you've learned so far in the rock climbing and the kayaking in front of an audience.
Oh, no. I'm not sure she'll crack under the pressure or the pressure will help her.
I'm petrified and I certainly don't want to be seen to kind of lose the challenge in front of an audience.
Phew, what a day. Becky's really put the effort in. But despite doing quite well in the kayaking, I reckon when it comes to the rock climbing, Miss Chase has still got a mountain to scale. I hope that tomorrow's practice performance and a little bit more teaching will see her reach new heights. Otherwise, it's going to be a gungeon instead of goodies after Monday morning's exam.
Coming up, there's a bizarre breakfast, a wacky wall.
Have you seen the mud?
And a few watery wobbles. It's the morning of the practice performance, and I've got a surprise in store for our duo.
I've got a secret challenge for you both. Over breakfast, I want you both to steal food from other people's plates. Mom, Dad, and brother.
So you want me to steal off Becky's mum and dad's plates?
Yeah, that's right. You've got to steal 5 items. Sausage, egg, tomatoes, beans, and toast.
Do we need to eat it or do we need to keep it?
Well, you've got to eat it and say, this breakfast is lovely. Every time you do it, okay? You've got to say those words.
Right.
Off you go. It's the secret challenge.
Bon appetit.
I'll be watching to make sure they steal food from everyone's plates.
So where is the hutch? Whereabout is it?
Just down here.
Oh, behind there, yeah. And where's the actual rabbit?
In the
hutch,
maybe. Okay. Let's see that again. I think we have our first steal.
Miss Chase just stole some food from the mum's plate. That's hilarious.
Just laughing at the thought of the rabbit.
Yeah, popping around the garden.
Miss Chase is cracking up. Don't give the game away, Miss Chase.
Mum,
can I swap
places with you?
Don't be by your dad.
Yeah.
Good idea.
Yeah, come on, it's over here.
Becky has switched places on the table, so now she's got a prime location to steal her dad's food.
Oh, yeah.
Clever thinking, Becky.
So you know you're saying you're going to paint this wall?
Probably in the...
Where was it that you said you didn't like? Which part of it didn't you like?
Well, it used to be all this colour.
Yeah.
And then we put the screen paint on, but
where,
nice
whereabouts? Was it here? Over there?
Yeah, about there.
Right. Yeah.
Good teamwork, guys.
Yeah.
Over Becky's there. Managed to get some egg from Dad.
About there.
Right.
Yeah.
Mm. Really, I like it like that. Smell. I like it.
That's brilliant.
Because normally when you have a day do it, you do it one colour at the bottom.
Yes.
One colour at the top.
Yes.
So what do you do for the rail itself?
Yeah, no, but...
I bet they're thinking, why is Becky so worried about what colour we're going to paint the dado rail?
There's two colours.
Which rail are we looking at? No.
You see that in the dining room, there's two dado.
Which one, Dad? Can you just show me exactly? I don't know which one she's talking about.
I think she's talking about the dado, which is about this height on the wall. Okay.
Yeah. That's worth a replay. Miss Chase has nabbed the tomato from Dad's plate.
They're doing really well so far. I've stolen food from everybody's plate apart from Tom's. And I think that's going to be the most difficult of all, and it's nearly finished.
Tom, do you want some more toast?
Yeah.
Toast. Dad, I think you should have some more toast.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Tom's running out of food. Clever thinking, Miss Chase.
So where does that go to at the back?
Dad, I'm a bit
Well, it goes down that direction, and there's a couple there.
Ooh, that was close. Keep it together, Miss Chase.
And close at the back.
This is a really lovely breakfast.
Well done, Miss Chase. She's got some toast.
Did our coffee drop there?
Really?
Just check, Fulton.
I'll just have a look for
you. Yeah, I thought that. Did you let him out, Thomas?
Steady on, Becky. That's the last of the five items, but still nothing from Tom's plate.
Come on, this is not Susie, it's a very nice breakfast.
Unless he's in his little bedroom area.
Tom's finished his food. They've failed, unfortunately. No prizes for these two. I'm going to go in and break the news to them.
Too late to have breakfast before work.
Good morning, everyone.
Hello.
How are you lot? Are you okay?
I'm full, actually.
Yeah. What a massive breakfast.
Have you really? Yeah, I bet you have. How about everyone else? Did anyone notice anything a bit odd going off this breakfast, though?
Well, some of the conversation was a bit odd.
There's a lot to talk about dado rails and moving chairs.
Listen, guys, I don't know if you noticed, but your breakfast must have gone pretty quick this morning because these two were told to steal some of your food from your plate. Now, guys, you did do well. You did steal quite a bit of food.
Yeah.
But you didn't steal any food from Tom's plate. You failed the secret challenge.
Oh, I don't believe it. Tom, you ate your breakfast so quick we didn't have a chance.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Tom.
Yeah. I guess I'll see you for the practice performance, guys. Good luck with it, yeah?
Thank you.
Commiserations.
I did notice it was a bit unusual, Becky wanting to, you know, to move seats right in the middle of breakfast. So that was a bit strange. And Miss Chase was rather giggly, considering it was just morning breakfast time. So that was just a little bit suspicious, I would say.
Friends and family have arrived to give their support at the practice test.
Hello!
First up, it's rock climbing. Sort of.
Stretched out before you is what we call a climbing lawn. OK, so as you can see, it's exactly the same as a regular climbing wall, you know, with the footholds and the handholds, yeah?
Have you seen the mud?
Well, if it's not the height, it's the mud. Well, we could get
I'd
you climbing...
I'd rather have the height than that mud!
No, you've got to do this, OK? Here is your equipment. If you'd like to put this on and talk us through what you're doing.
Right.
Let's give her a round of applause, guys. Some support.
OK. Oh no, I need Becky to help me put this on.
We've done this before, you know how to do it.
Right.
Yeah, you tell her, Becky.
Right, that's... Becky, that's for me. You. Yeah. My helmet. Is that the right way?
Slowly but surely.
I need my mum to do it.
Not the best start to
Okay, okay, helmet's on. Helmet's on. Right. Now I need to do an 8-loop knot. 8-loop knot, and that has to go through my harness. Yep.
Yep.
And then I do a, oh my gosh, the mud. Through there, my double loop, double 8-knot loop. Oh, pressure, I hate pressure. Right, that's through there, follow my 8-knot round, back through.
Remember, you round. Need to get this right as well, because if this was in a real situation, you don't want to
there
be
we go.
Falling.
That's right, Becky.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah,
double knotted eight.
Double figure of eight knot.
Okay. Okay, so I'm ready.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Let's scale the heights or flats, as the case may be.
Ready, Beck?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay. So first of all, I'm going to put my first foot in, and my second foot. I'm going to
ignore the rope.
Okay. And I'm looking for my root.
Okay,
and round.
Becky, would you be using her hands at any point?
She did.
I forgot to put my hands in.
Yes, you have forgotten to put your hands in. Right, okay, start from now, come on.
Oh, please. Okay, my hands in. And again. And through. Okay, I'm trying to find that one. Okay, I'm at the summit.
Right, okay, you're at the summit. Now, would you like to abseil back?
Yes, please. Woo!
Go
Woo!
Yay! Okay, let's give her a round of applause. I've never seen anyone make such hard work of climbing a horizontal wall.
It's just because of the mud. Right. There's so much mud.
And that was the reason that you forgot
how I hate getting my hair wet? I hate getting my nails dirty.
Wow, okay. So, anything else at this point that you hate?
I don't like mud and I don't like getting wet, but...
Right, okay.
Too late for that now.
Yeah, not the right two challenges, I don't think, for you. Becky, if this wall was vertical, how do you think she'd have done?
Well, she would be in trouble.
Right.
You know,
Right, okay. So obviously lots of room for improvement there, Miss
Chase. Yeah, it's not my favourite thing, as I said yesterday. It's a sport, it's one of her hobbies that I just can't take to at all. I'm gonna have to do better in kayaking.
Okay then, well let's hope that you are better in the kayaking. It's time for part two of the practice performance. Okay, we want you to start at the orange buoy.
Okay.
And do a figure of eight in and around this middle buoy.
Around that one, yeah.
Right to the green one.
Yeah.
And then back to us.
Okay, I'm not too sure of my turns, but yeah, I'll give it a go.
Hope you don't capsize, but you should be used to getting the hair wet and everything by now.
Yeah, Johnny, I've got one question.
Go on.
Is there anything in there that could bite me?
Well, there have been sightings of a mere monster around these parts recently, so... No, I'm joking. No, there should be nothing in there that will bite you, okay?
Right. Okay?
The only thing you have to worry about and be scared of is yourself.
Right.
Okay. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay.
Off she goes. Right to the first orange point.
She's off to a good start.
Well done, Miss Chase. She's feeling really good.
She's still upright and she's even put in a spin.
Well,
Don't worry, Miss Chase. Don't worry. Okay, Miss Chase, off you go. Well done.
She's reached the orange buoy. She needs to make her way round in a figure of eight.
Remember, you're steering. Go on, keep going, Miss Chase.
Looks like she's starting to get tired. Hang in there, Miss Chase.
Come on, Miss Chase!
Come on,
Miss Chase! Oh!
Now she's got to make her way back.
Got to go. Oh, she's finding it really hard to control.
She's looking like a professional. Oh, not too fast, Miss Chase. Don't want to be falling in the lake.
Remember your steering!
Yes, brilliant.
Woo, well done, very good.
You're supposed to go round the buoy, not into it.
Oh, hey!
Yes! Yes. Well done! You're almost there!
She's done it! But what do her fans think?
She looked really professional when she did the 360-degree twirlies in the middle of her course.
I think she was better at the kayaking, really, because she put a lot of effort into it.
You did fabulously well to get from the start to the finish and back again
in one piece,
without getting your hair wet as well. So at this point, we've done the practice test in both hobbies. Which would you like the final exam to be on?
Probably kayaking, I think.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think so. Kayaking.
And Becky, which do you think is the strongest hobby at the minute?
I think probably kayaking at the moment, but we need some extra practice and I think we'll see how the next few lessons go.
That's right, Becky. With less than 24 hours to go before the final exam, there's still work to be done.
You've got to make sure that they go in vertical and that you twist it, OK?
Despite a solid effort in the kayaking, Becky's giving Miss Chase some final tips to help her with her steering.
OK, now try turning around doing forward strokes. One side. That's it, well done. Looking good.
It's back home and back to basics with the rock climbing.
The right loop knots. It's the bowline knots.
As Becky goes through the knots all over again.
Which is just your simple thumb knot that you use.
Even though Miss Chase struggled with the horizontal wall, Becky's not giving up.
Well done, you're doing really well.
The best thing that can happen tomorrow in the final exam is that whichever hobby I end up doing the exam in, is that I actually conquer it and I pass the exam. Miss Becky has taught me so much and I really don't want to let her down.
Whoa! I'm not to come down.
No, you're not.
No, I really am.
Right, you're so close to the top.
I'm coming down.
No, wait, listen.
I've got to go down.
You are so close to the top.
Yeah, I know. I've got to go down, Becky.
You can only say that you've got to the top.
No, I can't.
The worst thing that can happen tomorrow would be if... just to get something that we haven't done before
maybe she's like not confident.
Oh, I nearly did it.
You're so close.
Oh, it's just this fear thing.
And if she's just generally panics, I'm gonna get gunged, and so is she, and I just that'll be terrible. So fingers crossed that won't happen.
It's the day of the final exam, and Miss Chase is doing some last-minute revision. But which hobby will she be tested on?
You will be watching me at all times, checking that I'm not slipping.
Good morning,
my
weight. Hey. Everyone.
Good morning.
How are you doing? You're all right, everyone? Okay, I think that's enough swatting up for one weekend. Listen, are you ready to find out what the final exam is going to be on?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Here, well, here is the golden envelope.
Oh, no, I'm nervous.
The hobby you're going to sit the final exam on is rock climbing.
Oh, that's good.
That's good. Rock climbing.
You're going to be great.
It's off to the climbing centre. Good morning, everyone. Good to see you all again. Are you all doing all right?
Yeah!
If Miss Chase passes this final exam today, you're all going to win an amazing prize. It's a big day out.
Yeah!
However, if they fail, it's a gross, disgusting gunging for both of them.
Yeah!
What do you reckon? Should we welcome the stars of the show out here, guys?
Yeah!
Put your hands together for Becky and Miss Chase! It's the big day. It's been a mad weekend, hasn't it?
It has, yeah. It really has.
Put in a lot of hard work. Well, you've done all you can at this point, Becky. She's been quite a good teacher, hasn't she, Miss Chase?
Yeah, no, she has been fantastic. And this is the whole thing. I don't want to let 7OA down, I don't want to let Becky down, but I'm actually shaking.
Are you really nervous?
Yeah.
Guys, you think they'll be able to do it?
Yeah!
A lot of faith in you here. Now, it may surprise you that although I am a multi-talented TV presenter, I actually know nothing about rock climbing. Can you believe it? So, I'm going to get an expert to adjudicate today. She's been the British champion 7 times. Put your hands together, please, for Lucy Creamer! Lucy, thank you so much for joining us today from my hometown, Sheffield. What will you be looking for today from Miss Chase?
Well, I'll be looking at Miss Chase's safety skills, firstly, obviously very important.
Yeah.
Then looking at your technique, your technical ability, and obviously looking at a little bit of climbing knowledge, a bit of theory as well.
Okay.
Now, the final exam is going to be split into theory and, unfortunately, a few practical tasks. Yeah. Here is the deal. There are a maximum of 5 points available from this exam. Mm-hmm. You need to get 3 points or more to pass and win that amazing prize for the whole class. Anything less than that and it's a fail and a gunging for both of you. Okay?
Okay.
Miss Chase, are you ready for your first task?
Yep.
You can get a point for this.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. I want you to tie 2 knots, as I call them out. Now, if both are correct, you'll score 1 point. So, firstly, I'd like you to tie a figure of 8 knot.
Okay. Figure of 8 knot. Oh, no, hold on.
Just take your time. I know, it's hard under the pressure.
Figure of 8 knot.
Okay, yep. Now I want you to tie a stopper knot. Are you happy with that?
Yeah.
Okay, let's have a look at these 2 knots. Give them back to Lucy, our judge. First impressions, Lucy.
Well, considering the short amount of time she's had, not bad, not bad.
Okay.
I'll give these 2 a pass.
A pass, well done. Give her a round of applause. Well done. Are you ready for task number 2?
Yeah.
You can get another point for this. Okay, laid out over there is some essential climbing equipment. What I want you to do is pick out the right items, as I call them, but you've got 30 seconds to do it. I like to find a bowline knot.
Bowline knot?
Yes, that's right.
Bowline knot. That one?
Come on. I'm going to have to hurry up. Okay. That's half your time gone already. OK, a screw gate carabiner. Clove hitch knot.
Clove hitch knot. That one.
A belay device.
A B what?
Belay device.
Oh, that.
Snap gate carabiner. Your time's up.
That one.
I'll let you get away with that one. OK. Let's find out how you've done. Remember, you have to get all five correct to get a point. Firstly, did you find the bowline knot?
Unfortunately, she didn't.
Oh, no.
No.
She did so well on everything else, especially because you were really rushing.
Yeah.
She got everything right apart from the first one.
Oh, so unfortunately, it's a fail.
Oh, bad no. luck, Miss Chase. Well, don't worry, there's three more points available. You've got a point already.
Okay.
All three points are available in the final part of this exam. And this part of the exam is practical as well. Okay.
Can't.
You thought you'd get away with it, didn't you?
I can actually cry at this moment.
No, you'll be fine. Okay, okay, okay. We're going to be looking for three things here, and you get a point for each. We'll get a point for putting all the relevant equipment on safely and correctly. Mm-hmm. Secondly, we're looking for your climbing technique. And thirdly, you've got to retrieve five green flags that are strategically placed upon the wall.
Miss Chase needs another 2 points to pass, but will she be able to climb over 12 metres to get the last flag?
Are you ready?
I can't get up there. I really can't get up there.
Remember just all that I said to you, focus on the top, don't look down, just try your best.
OK, are you ready for the final climb, Miss Chase?
No.
But ready as you'll ever be, I suppose.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, firstly, for a point, I'd like you to put all the relevant equipment on safely and correctly and talk us through it mm-hmm. as you do it.
OK.
OK. Away you go. Let's give her some support, guys.
I'm just putting the harness on, my legs through the bottom, pull it up. Just do up that harness. And then, so a helmet.
Sorry, Becky, can you just help me out here?
Is it the right size?
Yeah.
Yep, he's got it.
Do that a little bit, it's too tight.
That'd be better.
It's a little bit tight, actually.
Is it? That's it.
Okay. And then feed this through. And then I have to do feed it back through to do my double 8-knot. So follow the rope round and through and back through there. It's a double 8-knot.
Becky, if I can't do it, I'm sorry.
You can.
Okay. I'll just
remember, you just need 2 more points for this last section out of a possible 3.
Okay.
Take your time, Miss Chase.
Okay, away you go.
Come on, Shay.
Looks like she's doing all right.
Miss Chase!
Brilliant. Okay, she's got 1 flag. 2 flags.
Come on.
You got the final point. the summit. Let's abseil you down and find out how you've done.
Get me down!
Oh, come here, come here.
Okay. Look, you're on the ground. You're on the ground.
Oh, I've never been so scared in my life.
You've done so well this day. Well done.
Okay, well, quiet, everyone. This is where we find out how Miss Chase has done and whether you're all going for that amazing day out or not, okay? She had to retrieve 5 green flags. Got 1. Got 2. Got 3. 4. And 5. So you've definitely got a point for that. We need 1 more point. You've passed the final exam. Okay. Would you say that Miss Chase put on all the relevant equipment safely and correctly on her own?
She had to ask a few questions, to be fair.
Right, okay.
Thermal safety checks.
Pass or fail for that?
Actually, I'll have to say a fail for that.
Okay. Well, you did have to ask a few questions, Miss Chase, that's bad luck. It's all resting on this one. Okay. We were looking for good climbing technique. How do you think she did there?
Considering how much climbing she's done, I thought she gave an absolutely amazing performance and her technique was very good.
Well, it's all down to this. Lucy, has Miss Chase passed the final exam?
Well, I would say it's a definite pass.
Yeah!
I'm really, really, really proud of her. I'm so pleased. She couldn't have done better.
I cannot believe how much I've changed in a matter of 1 weekend. Overcoming fears that I've had all my life.
This weekend's been absolutely amazing. It's been like one of the best weekends of my whole life. Ah, they did it! I am glad.
I know, they stole victory from the jaws of defeat.
And defeat has some pretty strong jaws.
Yeah. Tune in next week for another help. Teacher's coming to stay!
Stay up to date with Newsround. We'll be providing coverage across the whole of CBBC as England go in search of the World Cup trophy. Follow the progress of the England team from their camp near Johannesburg and find out just what the World Cup coming to South Africa means for the children living there.
Newsround World Cup specials weekdays at 6:25 on the CBBC channel.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come in, ready or not! Found you! You'll go! 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Coming, ready or not! Giddy, dick and dog! I like doing it. This is my new trick shot. Can you do a trick shot? Oh, yes, spank it over. Very good. I can hit it on each side of the bat.
Ah, brilliant.
I can use it as a football. Spank it over again. Good. I learnt this one in the Outer Hebrides.
All right.
Watch. It's all in the wrist.
Live video, live commentary and live text commentary. All online at bbc.co.uk/World Cup. Where you can also predict, play, view highlights and see the excitement of the World Cup unfold in our team tracker. The World Cup Online.